Welcome to the drawElements quality program demo. In this video, we are going to give a short overview of the key aspects of the drawElements quality program and its graphical user interface, the Candy. The drawElements quality program, or in short, the DEQP, is a powerful tool for evaluating and improving the quality of any computer graphics related system. The tests are written on top of Chronos Group's APIs and are currently available for OpenGL ES, OpenCL, and EGL. The DEQP allows us to get a good understanding on what is happening inside the graphics processing unit and how to find and fix any existing underlying issues. For this video, we will test an Android phone against our OpenGL ES 2.0 test set. The tests are always installed and run inside the device. We can retrieve the results from the device to a computer via any kind of TCP/IP connection or with other data transfer methods, such as a memory card. In this demo, we have connected the phone to our computer with a USB connection. Once retrieved, the test results are stored in a SQLite database and can be easily analyzed with the Candy user interface. It is possible to use also other user interfaces to analyze the test results if you already have a good system in use. But let's now look at the Candy tool and see what kind of results we can get from this phone. This is the basic view of the user interface. On the middle, you can see the list of several test batches that can be run. This is fully customizable, and we can create test runs consisting of any combination of the DEQP tests. We can also create custom test cases and add them to the list. Now let's see how the full test set of OpenGL ES 2.0 looks like. We can follow the test results updating in real time. The green color indicates how many tests have passed in each category, and the red color indicates how many tests have failed or are not supported by this device. We can stop and continue the test run at any point. If, for example, the device would crash, we can always continue the test run from the next test. We can also jump to any specific test case at any time and see how the device has handled it. As we can see, the DEQP has already found failed tests in the device, and we can easily analyze both the overall pass rate of any category and also the details on very specific test cases. The test log on our right-hand side acts as a useful aid for pinpointing where the problem is. For regular tests, you can go through the test script itself, and in image comparison tests, you can see the expected image, the result image, and a comparison mask. All of the data here is exportable for HTML for making bug reporting easier and faster. Next, we will look at the different test categories of the DEQP. The DEQP tests are divided into multiple test categories, each focusing on a different aspect of quality. In our OpenGL ES 2.0 test set, we have tests for capability, functionality, accuracy, performance, use cases, stress, and scene captures. Let's look at some of the categories in closer detail. In functional tests, we are testing the GPU against the OpenGL ES 2.0 specification. Here we have focused strongly in shader tests, which are a complex area of the specification. The names of the test cases and the test log on the right-hand side helps us to pinpoint where exactly we can find bugs and we can start analyzing what may cause this issue. The accuracy tests measure the precision of the GPU. Here, for example, we have tests for texture filters, interpolation, and rasterization. In this category, the tests do not simply pass or fail, but the GPU gets a numeric result on how precise it has been on each test case. Our performance tests provide an excellent view on multiple different aspects of the GPU performance. Here we can analyze, for example, how texture formats and blend effects behave, how well transitions are handled in compilers, and we can measure the speed of new shaders. Just as with the accuracy tests, here the GPU gets a numeric value based on how well it has performed. The use case tests go through tests that are more complex and closer to the actual use of the device. These tests are combining multiple effects to see how the device can handle a more demanding graphics environment. Here, for example, we have some rendered scenes and user interface tests. As one of the newest features, we have added some capture tests which analyze the graphics quality on real programs. This time, we are testing a popular game by Mountain Sheep called Ice Rage. This test category is really convenient to check how a device can run actual applications on the market. It also benefits application developers to test for any porting issues between different devices. In the final section of this video, we are going to look at some examples on how we can analyze the test results. Here we are on the View section of the Candy tool. We can look at any previously made test run and open it again to analyze results. We can jump into any test case and see how the device has handled it. We can also compare test runs between any number of different devices to pinpoint their key differences. Let's select three commercially available devices that have been tested with our OpenGLES 2.0 test set. We can easily see the overall differences between the devices, and we can filter out any test failures, crashes, or results that were different. We could also do this comparison between multiple driver versions of the same device to see what the effects of the changes have been. This is especially useful in a long-term development work where you want to ensure that updates do not introduce any new problems to the device. In the comparison, we can jump into any test category and see in great detail how the devices are different. We can easily see passing and failing test cases and compare numeric values on very specific accuracy and performance tests. This helps, for example, to find out where the major problems and bottlenecks are. Again, if we are interested in a specific test case, we can easily open it to see what has happened in the device. From this data, we can also create comparison charts to better visualize the key differences of the devices. And again, we could create similar charts on different driver versions or any other important data, and export it if necessary. This concludes the drawElements quality program demo video, in which we looked at the basic features of the software. If you have any questions or wish to receive more information on the product, please contact sales@drawElements.com.